Hey, I'm Anthony, this is Ryan, and that's Jill, and we are 3D filmmakers. As you can see, we have quite the collection of 3D Blu-rays, and since these guys are expensive, we're going to be reviewing them, and letting you know which ones to buy and which ones to pass on. We're going to be reviewing everything from the blockbusters, to the little guys, and everything in between. So check us out, let us know what you think, and subscribe please.
Hey, Jill, what movie would you like to watch today?
Ooh, let's see here.
Mars in 3D.
Okay.
This half-hour-long documentary was produced in 1978. It focuses on the Viking mission to Mars, which is the first US probe to make it to the surface of Mars. The film overall I thought was very interesting. It is an educational film. It's not the most engaging documentary in the sense there's no drama. They just sort of explain the Viking probe and show you how some of it works with a model demonstrating what it does on the surface of the planet and then narrates images from the surface of the planet.
It was really interesting. They had a very detailed look at how it was just scanning vertical pixels and just transmitting that back to Earth.
It was interesting to see how rocky and like how incredibly like open and vast, like just, it looked like a magic eye, like picture, so much texture and just such a big planet. So it was cool to be able to see that.
Yeah, I thought it was great being able to see it in 3D. The images are taken from two cameras that are 0.8 meters apart, which is much further than you would normally shoot 3D. That was intended to get like good topographical data, not to present it like your 2012 Hollywood 3D movie. I thought it was really interesting seeing the surface that way because it exaggerates the depth and it made Mars look much more expansive. You could see like individual rocks and mountain ridges pop out in a hyper stereo effect that you wouldn't get if it was, say, the distance of the human eye apart. It did have issues with things in negative parallax.
You could focus on the middle and then that would help you kind of see the horizon, but anything that was close was just really invasive.
But the narrator walks you through that and explains why it is like that. There's also one camera taking images from different orbits. So there's difference in the shadows, and that's a little hard to watch. But you can still see depth.
It was also very useful for them to help map the surface in figuring out how the planet was formed. You saw the volcanoes and the lava flow, impacts from different meteors. Like without the 3D, you would have been like kind of guessing at what the pictures meant. And the sound was also, it set the atmosphere pretty well. Creepy, spacey, ethereal.
I thought the narration at times was a bit heavy on the kind of how-to, but if you don't know anything about 3D and you haven't seen anything outside of the modern 3D movie in the theater, it was good because it was informative, like this is what you want your eyes to do without being overly technical to the layperson, so.
It's an interesting glimpse into the time and the technology that they had back then. If you like IMAX documentaries like Space Station 3D or Hubble 3D, if you've been following the Curiosity mission, you might want to check out Mars in 3D.
I'd give it a slow panning thumb up.
I would also give it a very 3D thumb up.
I'm gonna give it just a regular thumbs up this time. It was good. Informative. I liked it.
Join us next week. There'll be a new video posted next Thursday.
Ooh.